Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in North Carolina. Hope you guys are doing all right. God bless you guys. I want to pray and try to give a word for a few people. I play music in the background when I'm going to do a video of words for people. I try to hear better from the Lord. My computer, I guess, is about 2 years old now. It's getting a little bit slow on me, but it's still able to, you know, even no matter what you do to them, they just get slower, you know, with, as they get older and stuff, you know, all this stuff that's on there, and trying to keep the music and the video and the, you know what I did? You guys have been watching my videos. I usually have a written down prayer request list, but what I did is I made a WordPad list so I could read my own handwriting. So that should help, brothers and sisters. So let's try. This is not the exact music I wanted to play for the anointing of the Lord, but sometimes, for those of you who don't know, sometimes some songs are more anointed than others. And we just don't, you know, it's different seasons and different timings with God. And when we flow in that anointing, that's when the gifts of the Spirit are much more strong and acute, you know. Just like we see, I think it's Elisha. The king of Israel and the king of Judah came together and they said to him, you know, they wanted to know whether they should make a battle and what they should do. And Elisha said, bring me someone, you know, to play an instrument and worship the Lord, and then I can hear from the Lord. And he told him to dig these ditches and stuff, and then they filled up with water. But anyway, so the worship music, people praying in the Spirit, praying in tongues, praying. The Bible says, build up your most holy faith, praying in the Spirit. The Bible tells us when we're praying in the Spirit, it's speaking in tongues to ourselves, between ourselves and God, edifying our, you know, God, and speaking just between you and God. Not the gift of tongues for public edification or and for interpretation, but praying in the Spirit is you are talking to God in an unknown tongue, and you're speaking to God and you're edifying God. And then and Paul said, when I pray in unknown tongue, like in this case, I pray that I may have the interpretation also, so that I can know what I'm talking to God about. Sometimes the Lord will give us interpretation, sometimes he doesn't, because sometimes things are a mystery. And I'm doing a little teaching right now, this FYI, as the Lord leads me to put out teachings here and there about it. But it's like this. I prayed with people before. I prayed with someone and there was a mystery that God didn't want anybody to know, but God wanted it uttered into this world. Just like when God said, let there be light, there was light. God wants things spoken into this world. And then, you know, God's word will not return to him void. He speaks it and then it becomes. God calls those things that are not as if they are. So he speaks it by his own self, through angels, through people, and then it has power in the words as it's spoken by his Spirit. So as an example, I can be praying with you and suppose that you are having an affair on your spouse. God doesn't want to expose you. God doesn't want to tell me. God doesn't want to expose it to people. I would lay hands on you and pray in an unknown tongue, not get an interpretation. But the Holy Spirit just prayed through me that you would repent of your adultery without exposing you. Because in this, as an example, in this case, God is giving you space to repent. And then later on, if you don't repent, then God will, you know, eventually will expose you to your spouse, to your family, to the world, and humiliate you, if necessary, to bring you to repentance. And so that's a word I have for whoever's listening to this. And I know who the person is, I'm not going to say. This person who's watching this, you know who you are. You need to repent of your adulterous relationship because the Lord is going to expose you. The Lord is going to expose you. The Lord will expose you. He gives you a chance to repent. And then, you know, there are times when your spouse doesn't need to know about it because it would hurt them more than the Lord wants. And, you know, the Lord doesn't want anybody to be hurt. But if that's what it takes to get you to repent so you're going to go to heaven, God will do it. You know, that's how the Lord operates. But anyway, brothers and sisters, let's go. You know who you are. I've already given a word for this same person, and it was a harsh word, a strong word, and they didn't want to receive it in the past, and now I see where the connection is coming from. All right, I'm going to pray right now, and I want to give words for people as the Lord leads me. Let's pray. I ask you to come in agreement, because prayer is beyond space and time. As we pray, this word will go forward, just like if you prayed with me on this video 6 months from now. God is outside space and time. You're praying with me as if you're praying with me right now as I'm doing it. We're in eternity together by the Spirit of God. We're seated, the Bible says, we are seated with Christ in heavenly places, far above all powers and principalities. We're above everything the enemy can do, above angels, above this earth, above creation. We're seated with Christ at the right hand of the Father right now by His Spirit. Let's pray. Let's pray. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for all those whose names that I will give tonight and give a word for, Lord. We come in agreement that the Lord would comfort them, would guide them, would rebuke them when necessary, to be instant in season and out of season, to rebuke, to exhort, to comfort all who need to be comforted, all who mourn. For your word says, Lord, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. And cursed are those who laugh now, for they shall mourn. Lord, that your word is sharp as a two-edged sword. So there is the comfort of your word and also the rebuke of your word. So, Father, we receive what we need, whether it be rebuke or comfort, Lord God. For your word says that rebuke a fool and you will endure his wrath. If you rebuke a wise man, he will take it to heart. And, Father, we know your word is true. And we honor you and we love you, Father, in the name of Jesus. All right, let's begin to pray individual names right now. I want to pray for Kimberly B. right now. Kimberly B. in the name of Jesus. Let's come in agreement, brothers and sisters, and pray for Kimberly B. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we declare victory, victory, victory right now for Kimberly B. I declare that no weapon formed against you, Kimberly B., shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against you, thou shalt condemn. This is the inheritance of the saints of God, and their righteousness is of me, says the Lord. I believe that's Isaiah 54:17. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory as we pray for Kimberly B. And the word of the Lord says, let God be exalted. Let God be true and every man a liar. As the word of God also says, Kimberly B., let God be true and every man a liar. For the Lord will set at naught those things. The Lord will set at naught those things that are of this world in Jesus' name. Now, set at naught means to make it of no effect, to do away with it. I think it's spelled N-A-U-G-H-T. Set at naught to make it of no effect, to do away with it, to cancel it like zero, to make it a zero. Kimberly B. Since I'm using the word pad for the first time, I'll put a little mark by your name so I know that I did it. All right, husband Steve and wife Jenny. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Father, we just bring husband Steve before you and his wife Jenny in the name of Jesus. Now, Father, we give you the praise and the glory, Lord God. We honor you. We praise you, Lord God. I hear the word exaltation. I hear the word exaltation. Father, we give you the praise and the glory. I see like a table, like the marriage supper of the Lamb, or a communion table, and it is golden. And then I see like a fetus, a baby that's in the womb, you know, like an unborn child. And then I heard the word exaltation. And then I see a wheelchair. And then I see someone in a detective outfit, but it is black. I'm just laying out what I see. I see these images. Lots of times I see images and then I get a word that goes along with it. I just said all those things. And the word I got is exaltation. Husband Steve and Jenny. Father, we give you the praise and the glory in the name of Jesus Christ. I just want to say this real quick, brothers and sisters. I know most of you know this. Words of wisdom and words of knowledge and prophecy and all this stuff is from 1 Corinthians chapter 12. This is from the Lord. We do it by the Spirit of the Lord. And there are people that do divination, and they don't do it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. They do it like by a demon spirit, like these psychics on TV. No, it's totally different. That's totally different. The word from the word of wisdom and word of knowledge, those other things, the psychics and all that, and tarot card readers and all that, that is a perversion and a cheap imitation of the Spirit of God. That's just like, evil music, rap music about raping and pillaging and killing, and rock music and devil music and all that. But the real music is the worship music that's in heaven, of course. Sex between a man and wife, between a husband and wife, is a gift of God and a beautiful creation of God for procreation. But yet homosexuality and bestiality and all that is a perversion of God's perfect thing. All things that God has created, the devil tries to pervert, and giving people words is one of them. Now there's lots of Baptists and people like that, denominational people, who, well, the people that's left liberal of Baptists don't even believe the Bible is really the Word of God. They believe it's all allegoric. They don't even believe it's really literal. Okay, but then there's the Bible, the people who take the Bible literally, who are not Pentecostal people, who think that all of the gifts of the Spirit and all that ceased with the, when the last apostle died. They call them cessationalists. And they also believe that, you know, only the apostles could operate in the gifts, where clearly lots of people in the book of Acts we see operating in the gifts of the Spirit. As an example, Ananias, who laid hands on Paul, operated in many of the gifts of the Spirit. But brothers and sisters, like I say, I'm just touching on this theology as I go on to the next name. Right now, I'm at Ashley, and I just put on here that she's 14 years old. Ashley, who is 14? Let's pray for Ashley, who is 14, in Jesus' name. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, I speak life, 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 and life abundantly. John chapter 10:10, the Lord is saying, you know, that He gives you life and life to the fullest. Life abundantly for you, Ashley, who is 14. Abundant life the Lord will give you in Jesus' name, according to His word, John 10:10. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise and glory in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I want to skip down because there's someone who asked me for a word, who needs a word today. So I don't want to make them wait too long. 1 for Yeshua. 1 for Yeshua, one of the viewers from YouTube. She asked me yesterday. She said she needs to know a word right now about something important. Now, sister, our brother, say that because your name, you don't say in your name whether you're a man or a woman. 1 for Yeshua. You know, God doesn't always say what we want to hear. Let me say that. If you're desperately seeking a word, sometimes He answers that. And sometimes the Lord tells us what we need to hear, not what we want to hear. So everyone always keep that in mind. I have several people ask me, they'll tell me, this 1 for Yeshua didn't do that, but a brother or sister. But lots of people who ask for a word, they will be like, they email me and I tell people I want details. Some people message me this long details and say, I need to know a word about this specifically. God doesn't, you know, bow to our demands. Sometimes He answers us specifically what we're looking for, but He tells us what we need to hear, not what we want to hear, brothers and sisters. And that's usually people's problem. They're usually asking their own question. And God gives us the right answer and the right question, okay? So, 1 for Yeshua, right now, we come in agreement, brothers and sisters. Pray with me, because this is some people's situations is more important than others, and she says her situation is very important. So let's pray right now in Jesus' name, or her name, his or him or her. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Father, we give you the praise and the glory as we pray for 1 for Yeshua. And Father, we just honor you, Lord. We honor you. We honor you, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory. And I hear the expression, get in the mix. Get in the mix, 1 for Yeshua. Get in the mix. Father, we honor you. We praise you in Jesus' name. Lord, let's continue to pray for 1 for Yeshua. Hallelujah. Father, we honor you, we praise you, we worship you, we glorify you. Blessed be your holy name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Halabusikinaromoi. Hakuma sima Yahweh. Halusikinarobu sabada Yahweh. Hallelujah, Lord. You are altogether lovely. Hallelujah. You are altogether worthy. Hallelujah. You are worthy. Hallelujah. You are worthy of all praise and glory. Hallelujah. 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 The Lord is saying he used a word that you very rarely hear people use. So that's one way you know it's the Lord too. It's a word, language you don't normally use. And the Lord said, I shan't do it, which I shall not. The Lord said, what I told you to get in the mix. And then I heard the Lord is saying, He shan't do it. He will not do it. He shall not do it. The Lord shall not do it. 1 for Yeshua. And I ask you guys to continue to pray for 1 for Yeshua. This is an important prayer request. I don't know what it is, but I know that it's important. And I got to ask you guys to continue to pray for that right now in Jesus' name. All right, brothers and sisters, We're going to Jessica S. Jessica S. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Lord, we give you the glory, we give you the praise, we exalt you, Lord. I hear the word systematically. Systematically. For Jessica S. Systematically. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You guys, I ask you to come in agreement with me as we pray for Jessica S. Hallelujah. And here you are systematically going through the motions. You know, and I would say, I don't know, it's probably the Lord's talking about religion. Could be talking about your job or something like that. But you're systematically going through the motions. In other words, you know, like, you know, going to a ceremonial church and doing all this kind of stuff, but it's just going through the motions. And I assume the Lord is talking to you about religion. You know, you're systematically going through the motions where you need to have a real personal experience with the Lord and personal relationship with the Lord. But, it, you know, and a lot of times the Lord tells me specifically, but I always say that because, you know, he could be talking about your job or your relationship, you know, with a man or whatever, you know. But I assume the Lord is talking about your relationship with him. You're systematically going through the motions. So, you know, you need to have a real relationship with the Lord, a serious relationship with the Lord. You need a breakthrough. And that's what I'm hearing from the Lord. You need a breakthrough. You need a breakthrough. You need a breakthrough, Jessica S., and I declare it, decree it, and you guys come in agreement with me. I speak right now, breakthrough to the Most High God in Jesus' name. A breakthrough and a bypass of secondary things and secondary issues. Jessica S., in the name of Jesus, your mind is tied up with secondary issues, secondary things, running to and fro. But you need to have your mind. The Bible said his mind is kept in perfect peace who stayed on the Lord. Keep your mind on the Lord, not on money. Not on money situations and things like that, but keep your mind on the Lord. Brothers and sisters, I just want to say, there's how many people I've stepped out and given a deep word and a specific word, like Sister Jessica. Sometimes it's just a word of exhortation, like some of the other people. And then sometimes it's really deep. And then a lot of times people private message me and say, wow, that's exactly, you know, even though some people put public messages, it depends. And I thank the Lord, because it's only by his Spirit. You know, like I say, it amazes me. Very few people are doing this, even though there's lots of people with different kinds of gifting. Because the Bible says, prophesy according to your faith. I believe it's Romans 13. You know, you got to prophesy according to your faith. If you don't have the faith, you can't do it. It's like walking on water or anything else. If you don't have faith, you can't do it. With anything with God, without faith, it's impossible to please God. And I know the Lord will use this to open the door for me to go to churches and then bring the gospel revival message of holiness and repentance. This is a doorway and an avenue to bring a revival and repentance. Starting even in New York City, I know the Lord's going to make a way in Jesus' name. Let's go to Roxanne W. Roxanne W. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Roxanne W. And I say that the Lord gave me this expression. I'm the King of the Most High God. How could somebody be the King of the Most High God? King of the Most High God. And I don't know what that means, but I thank you, Lord Jesus, right now. Hallelujah. I guess Jesus, the Lord is just speaking to me. Jesus is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Jesus is the King. Of course, the Most High God is the Father. Hallelujah. So the Most High God has a King, and it is Yeshua HaMashiach. Jesus is the King. The King of the Most High God. Hallelujah. That's a title I've never heard or ever thought of for the Lord, but the Lord just spoke it to me, Roxanne. Roxanna or Roxanne W. Roxanne W. R-O-X-A-N-E. So I guess that's Roxanne, not Roxanna. Roxanne W. So sister, I believe, you know, I don't know if it's specifically for you, but it would say to me that to know that Jesus is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He is the Christ. He is the Messiah. He's the Son of the living God. And he is our King. And he's the Most High God's King, our Lord Jesus Christ. He's the King over all things. Hallelujah. He has all authority in heaven and earth, the Lord Jesus Christ. So Roxanne, I ask you to put your complete faith and trust in the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He is with you. If God be for you, who can be against you? And what the Bible verse is coming to mind for is from Psalm 1, verse 1. And it says, you know, blessed is he that, you know, doesn't stand in the way of the wicked or in you know, go read Psalm verse 1. It's basically saying, you know, don't hang out with evil people and all that kind of stuff, but, you know, stays and walks with the Lord and walks in holiness. You know, he is like a tree that's planted by the water and will not be moved. I believe that's Psalm 1 and Psalm chapter 1 verse 1 and 2. So, but the verse that I heard was, you know, blessed is he that doesn't stand in the way with the wicked. It's the part that I heard for you, Roxanne W. You know, blessed is he that stays away. You know, don't be mingling, hanging out with evil people, but instead hang out with holy people and Christian people, holy brothers and sisters in Christ. You know, what fellowship has darkness with light? But have fellowship with light, the Bible tells us in the New Testament. Jocelyn W. Oh, J-O-L-O-Y-C-E. Jolice. I'm sorry, I can't. Even when it's legible, I can't read it. Jolice W. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray for Jolice W. Lord, we lift her up to you, Lord God. We give you all the praise, all the glory. Hallelujah. There is a fountain who is a king. Hallelujah. There is a fountain who is a king. Hallelujah. There's a fountain flowing deep and wide. Hallelujah. It's two different songs. Deep and wide. The kids' song. Deep and wide. There's a fountain flowing deep and wide. That's a river of the living God. Jolice W. Maybe you're praying about being baptized in the Holy Spirit, being filled with the river of the living God. And I'm going to tell you right now, get into the river. Dance in the river of the Most High God. For there is fullness of joy, and the Lord is, you know, full of glory and joy unspeakable in the river of the Most High God. That crystal clear river that flows under the throne of God and the love of God through the blood of Jesus that flows from Emmanuel's veins. God bless you, J-O-L-O-Y-C-E, because I'm trying to think of what the Lord is speaking to me while I'm trying to say your name. The Lord is with thee. Lift up thy countenance and straighten the feeble knee, for the Lord is with thee. The Lord is with thee. Yea, he will strengthen thee. Yea, he will give you the glory in Jesus' name. He will put his glory upon you and give you the victory in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Vasily from Nantes, France. V-A-S-I-L-E from Nantes, France. Vasila. I don't know how to pronounce it. Vasila. Father, right now we come in agreement, brothers and sisters, to pray for Vasila. From France, Father, we give you all the praise and the glory right now. Father, we honor you. And the word here is, thanks be to God who causes us to always triumph in Christ Jesus. That's a Bible verse for you, Vasali. Thanks be to God who causes us to always triumph in Christ Jesus. We always triumph in Christ Jesus. He's given us the victory in Christ Jesus. The Father has. You've got the victory, Basiles from France. You have the victory in Christ Jesus. You know, stay in Christ, abide in Christ, and you have the victory. The Lord has given you the victory through Christ Jesus. He calls you to always triumph in Jesus' name. I ask you guys to pray for our brother in France. Father, right now, I'm praying for Sheila from the Ultimate Gift Shop in Cadillac, Michigan. Sister Sheila from the ultimategiftshop.com, I think it is, in Cadillac, Michigan. She sent me some nice polo shirts. I was wearing one, a blue one, in the video I made the other day. I forgot to thank her. You know, anything that someone has sent me is a blessing. Like Brother Brian has sent me the Sacha Icha, the plant from Peru that's a substitute for fish oil that I talked about before. Talk about it again next time. Let's pray for Christian businesses. If you need some stuff, if you go online, get a chance, you want to buy some stuff, check out the ultimategiftshop.com in Cadillac, Michigan. It's a Christian business. Let's help our Christian brothers and sisters, you know, be prosperous so they can also be blessed so they can become a blessing and promote the gospel in the world, brothers and sisters. So, Father, right now, let's pray for Sheila, the ultimate gift shop right now, in Jesus' name. Father, right now, we speak your blessings upon Sheila. And Father, we declare victory. We declare no weapon formed against her shall prosper. In Jesus' name, right now, Lord, I speak light of the world. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus is the light of the world, and he wants you to be salt and light. Right now, in Jesus' name, in Cadillac, Michigan, hallelujah. Let the salt and light go forth from the ultimate gift shop. Lord God, we give you the praise. We honor you. We glorify you. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Lord, I just speak your blessing upon the ultimate gift shop, Lord, that it will be used to bring glory to your name, to bring the light of the gospel to the Gentile world in Cadillac, Michigan, and beyond, to the world, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Lord. We speak your blessings right now. I ask you guys to come in agreement. We speak blessings of the Most High God upon the ultimate gift shop and upon Sister Sheila, who works there, in Jesus' name. Lord God, let your power, let the fountain of your love go forward through Sister Sheila and her business, Father, in Jesus' name, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord. Bless all Christian business people, Father, with fourfold wisdom, fourfold finances, fourfold ministry, fourfold opportunities, Lord God, and business to serve you and bring glory to your name, Lord, and prosper in Christ Jesus, Lord God, that they can be blessed so that they might be a blessing, Lord, just like you did with Father Abraham. In Jesus' name, Lord, you said you blessed him to make him a blessing, Father. We honor you, Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, for your blessings. Hallelujah, Sheila. I just hear from the Lord that there is a root. I said all those things about you, but I think it's root of bitterness. I heard from the Lord there's a root that needs to be plucked out. So, and I believe that, you know, the only root I know in the Bible talks about a root of bitterness. So, what if, you know, we all have a past. We all have, you know, if we search our hearts, we'll all see. And I ask all of you guys, not just Sheila, all of us that search our hearts, we all have some unforgiveness maybe in our heart. You know, and the Lord said if we, you know, we need to forgive others, that the Father would forgive us. For the Lord has forgiven us of a huge debt. We should forgive others of their small debts, even as the Lord said in the Lord's Prayer. You know, if we forgive our debtors as you forgive us, Lord. So, as you forgive our debt. So, brothers and sisters, search your heart right now. And Sister Sheila, search your heart. You know, that we would forgive any that we have aught against. You know, like in Mark chapter 11, verse 22 and verse 23 and 24, when Jesus is talking about having faith, you know, when he cursed the fig tree, he said first, 22, Mark 11, 22, have faith in God. You know, and he says, for whomsoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in the heart those things that he saith, he shall have those things that he saith. And then right after he says that, he says, and if you have any aught against anyone, if you have any problem with anybody, any unforgiveness, any conflict, you know, first forgive your brother, then, you know, you're going to pray for this, you know, for this mountain to be moved. So we must first get any root of bitterness out of our heart by forgiving and turning the other cheek of anybody in any situation. That's for all of us. And we all, you know, have little things that we forgot about, but it's still there. So I ask all of you guys, let's come in agreement right now in the name of Jesus, Father. Father, you know, sometimes, you know, in our flesh, of course, it's hard to forgive sometimes. Lord, it's not by might or by power, but by your Spirit, Lord God. Father, we ask you to give us the grace and the mercy to forgive, Lord. Help us to forgive, Lord. We release and we forgive any that we have a problem with, Lord. Lord, help us, strengthen us to do it, Lord. We can't do it in our flesh, but by your Spirit, Father, in the name of Jesus. All right, brothers and sisters, we're at 30 minutes. I want to do one more. LaDonna P. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, we come together in agreement to pray for LaDonna P. We declare victory for LaDonna P right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I speak right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We speak victory right now in the name of Jesus for LaDonna P. Hallelujah, Father. We give you the praise and the glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father. We just pray your blessings upon LaDonna P in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. We give you the praise and the glory, Lord. I hear the word self-righteousness. LaDonna P, I don't know if that's you or someone around you, But you know, when the Lord says someone is self-righteous, it's saying that you're relying on your own righteousness and not that of the Lord. So, LaDonna, we must first, of course, realize that it is by grace we are saved through faith, not of our own, but a gift of God, not by the works that we can do, lest any man should boast. LaDonna, maybe that's for you or maybe someone you're dealing with. I don't know. And anyone listen to this, whenever I'm given this information, I know lots of you guys are watching it. You know, it's for all of us. The things I'm saying is for the whole body of Christ. This is pastoral counseling that's been given to me by the Word of God and by His Spirit, that is for all of us, including myself, brothers and sisters. So whenever we start thinking that, you know, even as I mentioned before, just like Paul says at the end of Galatians, you know, people trying to follow the law and be circumcised. He said, I wish you would just go ahead and, you know, cut off the thing that's stumbling you, you know, emasculate yourself, chop it off instead of worrying about being circumcised. And I mentioned this before, 90%, and a lot of people who are viewing this are from Europe and stuff. They don't do circumcision in Australia and Europe and all that too much. America, though, I guess because we have lots of Jewish doctors who've taught at the medical schools, and it's a common practice in the United States to circumcise all male children, even though they're Gentiles. And as a matter of fact, now that number's come down, but it's over 90% of all American males are circumcised, where in the rest of the world, they're not doing that. So you viewers from other countries, you guys don't have that. It's America. And then these are people who are not Jewish. So even as I mentioned, there's probably Americans, men, who have it in their mind that somehow that they're even thinking, oh, I've been circumcised, so that's why America is a great nation, because we have so many circumcised men. There are people that believe anything, brothers and sisters. They rely on self-righteousness, not by grace, but by their own deeds. As the Bible says, you know, our deeds, our works are a filthy rag in the eyes of the Lord. So, Sister LaDonna, I don't know if it's you or someone you're trying to minister to or family member or whatever you're dealing with, or even yourself and anybody that's watching this. To be self-righteous is to think that because I'm doing such a good job, God loves me more because I'm doing such a great job. And it's an easy trap for any of us to fall into. It's a very easy trap. Brothers and sisters, we must be careful not to become self-righteous, that we always humble ourselves. And just like Jesus told the story, I've repeated this many times, I'll repeat it again. Jesus tells the story of the Pharisee, the publican, which is a tax collector. He went into the temple along with one of these Pharisees, like a rabbi from the Pharisee school of belief of the Jews. And the Pharisee looked up to heaven and said, you know, thank you God, I'm not like this tax collector. You know, I fast twice a week, I tithe and blah, 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 blah. And then, you know, all these great things he had done. And Jesus is telling this story. And then the publican, the tax collector, didn't even look up to heaven. He looked down at the ground and smote himself in the chest, hit himself in the chest and said, forgive me, Father, you know, forgive me, God, because I'm a sinner. And Jesus said, that man, the tax collector, the one who did that is the one who was justified that day, not the Pharisee. The Pharisee was relying on his own righteousness. He was being self-righteous. Whereas the tax collector, the publican, was humble and said, hey, I'm a sinner, forgive me, God. That's it. Wouldn't even look up to heaven, you know, because he was ashamed of his sin. You know, and that's what the Bible tells us in many ways. And another one is God gives grace to the humble, but he resists the proud. God bless you guys. Love you guys. I'll come back again. I got a whole lot more names to do, but hey, you know, it's not a 30-second. This is not a 30-second bullet thing. This is to minister to people. And, you know, I'm determined not to worry about, you know, having, you know, becoming famous. But I'm determined to do the work of the Lord diligently. God bless you guys. Love you guys. Thank you all who prayed for us. You know, we're still, you know, dealing with the car issue. I know God will provide. And I thank all you guys for praying for us to go forward. I know the Lord will provide a vehicle that we need and to go forward and do the ministry. By the grace of God, the Lord has spoken to me about, and I've said this before, maybe on videos, you know, I want to go from place to place and plant churches, home churches. If I visit you, I ask you to pray about it. You can start a Bible study in your home. You know, we can have prayer. We can have a Bible study with prayer and pray over for people to be healed and all that kind of stuff. Salvation, of course. But we're talking about Christians, really, to be revived, to be used by God and all that, to disciple people in home churches. That's what I want to do. as one of the missions that I would do is I go from place to place. And there's many of you that already want to do it. Start a home church, like on a Friday night, Saturday night. Lots of people work on Sunday. Lots of people have an untraditional schedule. A lot of you guys on YouTube have an untraditional schedule. There's no law, as a matter of fact. You know, there's a dispute about going to church on Saturday and Sunday and all that stuff anyway. Every day of the week is holy as we have another rest. Hebrews chapter 3 and 4, we see there's another rest. It's a rest that's by faith. Not our Sabbath rest is by faith always. 24 hours a day, every day, we're resting by faith in Christ. We're in a Sabbath rest as Christians. Always. So anytime two or more are gathered in my name, Jesus said, there I am in the midst. That's the church. When two or more are gathered in his name, talking about him, praying, reading the Bible, studying the Bible, singing a song unto the Lord, we are in church. God bless you guys.